Alright folks, welcome back to the Don's channel. I am the Don Father and I'm about to do this reaction now for a channel patron of ours, and the request is They Call Me Doc by Creative Vets featuring Aaron Lewis, Vince Gill and Dan Tyminski. This is the official music video of it, so really looking forward to it. Everybody knows who follows the channel now. I love doing stuff with the military and paying my respects to what these guys do day to day for us overseas. I was a veteran, I'm a veteran myself. I was in the infantry, the British Army, so it's something very, very close to my heart. And anyway, big massive thank you to for the request. The link to this video will be in the description section below. Solely our Patreon account if you'd like a personalised video request and shout out, check that out, or simply join the channel as a member and get your request through that way. Don't forget to subscribe, like, comment and share and put the bell on, that would be great. And check out our Rumble account as well and subscribe there. It's the Don's channel, which is all one word. Thank you very much. Anyway, no more talking. Let's go!
They call me Doc, but I ain't got no degree. When the shit hits the fan, they're calling for me. From bluegrass Kentucky, with red blood on my hands, nobody calls me hero, except for my friends. Yeah, I woke up from dreams to find out that they were real. Well, I can tell you how it went, but I can't tell you how it feels. 'Cause I've seen it all, I helped heroes who fall and picked them up till they stand tall. And I've been in the field and worked down to the bone to make sure all my brothers get back home. I've shed the smiles, I've shed the tears, swore they'd make it out of here. When they scream, please make it stop. They call me Doc, they all know my name, 'cause it's stitched on my chest and it hangs on this chain. You won't read it in the paper or see it on the TV, but I don't need no fame, that's fine by me. Yeah, when they're broken, bruised, I know just what to do. My job always starts when their job is through. Yeah, I've seen it all, I helped heroes who fall, pick them up till they stand tall. And I've been in the field, worked down to the bone to make sure all my brothers get back home. I've shed the smiles, I've shed the tears, swore they'd make it out of here. When they scream, please make it stop, they call me Doc, they call me Doc. You never know the heartache of looking a grown man in the eye when he asks you, am I gonna make it? And you gotta lie. Yeah, they call me Doc, I ain't got no degree. When the shit hits the fan, they're calling for me. From bluegrass Kentucky, with red blood on my hands, nobody calls me hero except my old man. Yeah, they call me Doc.
Wow, what a powerful song that was. That got me a little bit emotional, that one, actually. I know how difficult it is for medics on the front line. Bearing in mind they're doing a job that is high pressured anyway, because they might be friends with some of these people who have been wounded, injured, whatever, shot, blew up, whatever horrors they might have had to endure on the day. So they've already got that sort of bond, possibly, between some of the people who they're having to go in and help. Then you've also got the added problem of there's potentially small arms fire coming at you. You're working under those conditions. Maybe mortars are landing on your position. You've maybe got the threat of other sorts of things, like suicide bombers if you're in the Middle East, or maybe there's other things happening in and around what's going on, and you're having to try and deal with really bad situation. Maybe you've got more than one casualty, you're trying to triage them. With all this going on, it's absolute chaos. It's a job that is so, so difficult, but one of the most important jobs on a battlefield. I can't express how much respect I have for the people doing it. Speak firsthand, I know that our regiment got hit with suicide bombings, roadside bombs, obviously small arms fire, mortars coming in. People lost their lives or were badly injured in certain, some of those attacks. And it's not always the first responder to it. The first medic there on site isn't necessarily extremely hit or highly trained medics that you would have that would be in the army. It's maybe ones from your own platoon who are higher battlefield first aid trained than what you all have. An element of first aid training, you're all carrying your own first field dressings, your own morphine, stuff like that. If you get injured, you can apply your own. If you're conscious, you can apply, and you're in pain, you've maybe something bad's happened to you, maybe a limb's been blew off or something's happened or broken leg, you'll be able to apply your own morphine if you're conscious. If not, there'll be somebody within your section, your platoon, that'll be able to do that for you. If you're conscious, you should be able to possibly do it yourself, providing you've got your hands. That's a sad fact of what you're facing. But the, as I said, you will have your own sort of basic battlefield first aid, which is actually quite a decent standard, and then you'll have trained medics within your platoon, your company, that will be there, that will not be proper medics, as I said, but they'll be at a higher standard. They can put drips in, but the pressure on these guys, the things that they've done, and I know what people had to endure that were with us, dealing with mass casualty, suicide bombing, and it was traumatic. Nothing but respect. Very, very, very difficult situation. High pressure, people panicking, people in battlefield shock, which were adding to making it even more difficult, things like that. So, yeah, these guys deserve a lot of respect for what they do, because it's difficult job anyway, being a, if you're a paramedic in the street, let alone maybe under the sort of added pressure of attacks happening at you at the same time. You could be under enemy sniper fire, small arms fire, maybe RPGs coming in, depending on where you're deployed. Of course, mortars raining in on top of you, and you've got to get that casualty out and get them to safety and be able to administer the best first aid you possibly can. Also, as I said, it could be a mass casualty situation where you're dealing with more than one casualty and you're trying to triage them with all of this going on. So it is a very, very, very difficult job, and they deserve the utmost respect from anyone. And that's what I'm going to say here. Any Marine, Army, whoever, soldier, Army, wherever, if you're on that front line, you're out on the ground patrolling and you get hit, you need them, you need these people, and you rely on, your life is in their hands basically. You've got to remember, if a lower limb's blew off, you've stood on like a mine or a roadside bomb or something and it's blew the leg off you, you're going to bleed out without somebody coming over and helping you as quickly as possible. So you need people at a competent level, but it is difficult, even for people trained. Nothing prepares you for real events, the brutality of combat and war, nobody prepares you for things like that happening, seeing guys with limbs missing, screaming, maybe they're visibly disfigured in their face or whatever. Nothing prepares you for that, so it is really traumatic for the people having to deal with it as well, and others who are within the platoon, maybe not injured, maybe not of a higher level of first aid, they could be helping as well, and it's a really, really difficult thing. So it's something that I'm glad was requested, because I know really close people to me, friends, etc., who have had to deal with that sort of thing, with your own friends maybe being injured as well, and it's not easy. That is not easy. So nothing but respect for them. It could have been anyone on the day, wherever. When you go out the wire, you don't know what's going to happen. You're going to get hit with a roadside bomb, you get suicide bombing, you're going to get sniper fire on, you're going to get RPGs firing it, you're going to get all these things happening. You don't know. It's just the situation is possibly wrong place, wrong time. And that is just it. It's just those split moments where somebody could be hurt or injured or killed, where somebody might have went down the road 2 minutes before them and nothing happened. So it's just one of those things. You never ever think it's going to be you. This is one of the things as well which is so strange about going on an operational tour. If you're in Iraq, Afghanistan, wherever you might have been deployed over the last 20 years, in a conflict zone or war zone like that, you never ever go out thinking you're going to be that person, but it very easily could be you. It could be the section next to you. It could be, you don't know. And many's a time we got our armoured fighting vehicles blew up, the tracks blew off them, roadside bombs underneath the vehicles, and injuring or killing people on the vehicle. So it's very real, and the job that the medics do is vital. And even the medics, not just the platoon ones now, the medics are actually in the medic part of your regiment or battalion or whatever you're serving with, they're of the higher level. Then obviously you've got the ones in the hospitals out in Afghanistan that are right there again of another higher level. But these people, their job is vital. The quicker you can apply first aid to anything, the better chance you have of saving, maybe it's a limb or saving someone's life at the end of the day. So, good request, an emotional request for so many different reasons. And I'd imagine for anyone watching this who's served in the military and maybe experienced things or whatever, it could be difficult for you as well, thinking about situations where medics have had to go in. Maybe you've been the medic, and you've had to go in, and nothing prepares you for that, and nothing prepares you afterwards for the trauma that might come. Obviously, people suffering from post-traumatic stress disorder, because of situations like that, they've maybe went in, they've been friendly with these boys, guys, whoever, men or women who's been possibly injured out there, been friendly with them over however many months to years, and then all of a sudden you're going in and you're having to see them in a situation that's not what you want to see somebody who you're really close with, and So thanks very much for the request, very difficult one. The link to that original video will be in the description section below if you want to check it out again. It's a beautiful song, beautiful tribute to people who really do deserve it. And you know what? They're not doctors, they're not trained at universities, but in some respects what they're doing is higher pressure than a lot of doctors might ever have to experience in their career. Some doctors might not have ever have anything as high as like a pressure cooker situation like that. Don't get me wrong, doctors in hospital have to experience so many different types of high pressure situations, but not all doctors. So it doesn't matter your degree, your qualification. It just matters that you go there and you try the best you can with the training that you have, and do it as quickly as possible, and hopefully you can save someone's life. But that's it. That's what it's all about at the end of the day. So thanks again. As I said, that video will be in the description section below. So will our Patreon account. If you'd like to become a patron, get a personalised video request or shout out, check that out, or simply join the channel as a member and get your request through that way. That would be fantastic. Don't forget to subscribe, like, difficult one to like. I like the song because it pays tribute. Like the video, of course. Subscribe, like, comment, share the video and put the bell on. That would be fantastic. Thanks very much for watching, everyone. I appreciate that. It's probably quite difficult for a lot of people who follow this channel. So, apologise for that. But I'm also not sorry because it's paying tribute to the work that these men and women do in these places to keep our troops safe and try and bring them home to their loved ones. So that's it. Thanks again, and I'll see you all soon. Goodbye.